In this vlog, we will try to see the implementation of unit testing in Flutter programming. So in our previous vlog, we have seen what is unit testing and why do we use it and what is the importance of unit testing in software programming. So if you have missed the tutorial, I'm providing the link in the description section below and I suggest you to go through it before starting with this particular tutorial. So now let's try to see the project structure over here. So here we have got lib folder in which we have main.dart file. So generally we start coding from this particular file in Flutter applications, and below it you can observe there is another directory called test here. So in this particular test directory we have got widget_test.dart. So this is our testing file here for main.dart file. These are the basic implementations which are provided by the Flutter team by default. So I'm just trying to remove all these things, and also I'm just going to remove this comment section to make it much more easier for you to understand like how we will do Flutter unit testing right from basic. So the very first thing we need to start with is like main.dart file here. Inside the main.dart file, I'm going to specify class main here. And also in this particular main.dart file, we are not trying to implement any coding here such that it will be having an output in our simulator. So here we don't require simulator for making unit test here. So I'm just closing the simulator for now. And here now let's try to add some code to our main.dart file so that we can test it. So let's try to consider a variable of type int here, and I'm specifying value to be 0 for it. So the initial value for the variable value is 0 here. And now let's try to specify two methods here. So for making this particular tutorial much easier for all of you, I'm going to consider the basic examples again so that you will understand the concept of unit testing and you can easily implement this particular concept to your code. So now let's specify void increment here. So this is our increment function here, and here for this what we will do is like we will consider the value and we will try to increment it here. I have just directly made use of arrow function and specified the value over here directly. So if you are not comfortable with using arrow functions, then you can just make use of the normal functions even. So this is for beginners, I am saying this particular suggestion. So first of all, my suggestion is to get clarity of the concept here, what we are trying to do, then you can just implement arrow function or normal function that doesn't bother the output here. So now let's specify decrement function even, and here the same we will do is like value decrement, we will try to add minus minus such that we can decrement the current value, and later we can just add few more functions and try to add their test cases and try to see how the thing works. So now we are done with the main.dart file for now, and let's move to the widget_test.dart file and start coding unit test cases for these two methods over there. So here let's start with test here. So within the test we need to specify the description for the test case here such that anyone can easily understand what this particular test case will perform. So value needs to be incremented. So this is what I am writing as a description for this particular unit test case, and let's specify an empty function, and here let us try to specify the actual testing scenario. So here you can notice that we are getting the function test isn't defined. So initially we have removed everything in this particular file, right? So we need to import flutter test.dart package here such that we can make use of test here and test our increment and decrement functions. It's very easy now. So let's try to create an object for main.dart here. So I'm just making use of final main equal to main, and now let's make use of this particular object here, and also you need to import main here. So import library. So this particular main.dart is now being imported to our test widget underscore test.dart file. And with the help of main here, you can access these two functions. And again, this is basic, and not only functions, you can also even access the variable over here. So now let's try to access the first function which we have specified, that is increment here. So we are now accessing the function increment here and trying to increment the value of this particular variable value here. So don't get confused, the name of the variable is value here. Let's try to add the actual statement here, which is expect. So whenever you start typing this particular word expect here, so here you can see we have got a suggestion for the expect here. So let's specify it actual and matcher. So what is actual? So main dot value is our actual here. So currently main dot value is 0, right? So that is what we have specified, main dot value. So value is equal to 0 here. And now whenever you are performing an increment here, what should be the output? Now I think you can guess it easily, right? So whenever it is 0 and whenever you are performing plus plus here, what will happen here? So plus plus, in the sense plus 1 will be added here. So 0 plus 1 will be, the output will be like 1, right? So let's specify 1 here. And this is it, our test case for the increment function is now ready and is ready for testing even. Let's try to run this particular test case and check whether this runs properly or not. So you can tap on the play button here, the green color play button over here, and tap on run here. So now our testing is started. It might take some time for you and wait for the output. We have got our test passed here. So there are total 1 test in our code and test pass 1 of 1 here. And now let's try to write the same for the decrement here. So here I will give a small break for you to try it and just pause the video over here and try to add a test case for decrement. And if you're not getting, just come back and we will try to code for decrement even. So I hope we have done with the decrement test case even. So let's try to add it here. So test, and let us specify, and again this description you can write according to your wish, but make sure that this description is been easily understandable by every developer who reads this particular code here. Value needs to be decremented. Okay. And again, same, add an empty function here. And let's create an object for our main.dart file here. And you might get a doubt over here, why we need to create main.dart file object twice here? We have already created in line number 9, right? So why do we need to create it in line number 15 again? Don't you think it is again using the same code multiple times? I will answer this particular question after running this particular test case. Okay, so let's try to make use of main.decrement now. And here in the expect, so what we are expecting here, so what will come under actual is like main.value, just like earlier we did. And matcher is like what will come over here. The initial value is 0, and 0 minus minus is like minus 1, right? So we will get here minus 1, and add a semicolon here. And now let's try to run the second test case over here and see the output again. And yes, you can see here test passed 1 of 1 here. So you might think we have got 2 test cases, right? Why it is getting 1 every time? So to make these 2 test cases run at once, so you need to run at void main here, we have got a play button here, right? So when you run from here, two test cases here you can see are now successfully passed here. And now we'll come back to this doubt over here, why we need to add or we need to create object multiple times here for each test cases. So can't we make it a global one and make use of it here? Yes, you can make use of it here, but your test case will fail now. So now let's try to run this code and see the output. Here you can see our test case, one test case is passed and another one is failed. So what happened? We have just moved a single line of code to global level and try to implement the same test cases, and the first one is successfully passed here and the second test case is failed. So what is the reason here and what actually happened? So any guesses over here? I think some of you might have got it correctly. So whenever you are trying to declare this globally here, what is the point happened here? Like, we have incremented the value here. So what happened? Instead of 0 here, it became 1 now. And yes, for the first test case, it passed successfully because 1 equal to 1 here and it is successfully done. And now when you come to the second test case over here, what happened here is like main.value. Now let's go back and see what is main.value here. It is 1 now. And we initially, at the time of creation of this particular test case, in our mind we have thought like main.value will be 0. And accordingly we have calculated 0 minus 1 is minus 1 here, right? So now what happened? Main.value. So every time main.value, in the sense value is a variable which we have specified in the main.dart class. Now the current value is 1, right? So 1 minus 1 is how much? 0. So now when you add 0 here, and so now let's try to run this code and see the output once. So now both of our test cases will pass successfully because as our value is 1 and 1 minus 1 is 0, and our test case is now successfully done. So I hope you understood, by declaring a main object globally, we are not trying to reset this particular variable here. So the variable value is continuing for the further test cases even. So that should not be done. So that is what the reason every time we are recreating the main object, so that we can make use of the value which is to be initialized to 0 every time. So I hope you understand this particular point, why we are adding main object inside every test case and not outside here. And also there are few other methods by which we can make it happen, but as this is the first tutorial, just try to understand this concept here, and in further coming tutorials we will try to handle this global level even. In our next tutorial we will try to see how to handle group test cases here. So for example, within the main.dart file you have different sections of codes here. So let's consider you have different modules of codes here and you want to handle them accordingly. So how we need to do that? So now I have again made this to be minus 1 over here, so that both the test cases will again continue to work the same way it was working earlier. So this way we need to add test cases to our basic methods here, which is increment and decrement here. So let's try to play with them further, and I will give you an assignment like, try to add one more function here and try to add the test case it over there, and the one more function is like increment plus 2 here. I'm just trying to create a function for you. So like increment plus 2 here. I'm also trying to specify how we need to increment it here so that it will be much easier for you. So now write a unit test case for this particular function increment plus 2. And if you are having any doubts, just let me know in the comment section below. And yes, this is it for this tutorial on Flutter unit test cases, and in coming tutorials we will try to learn more on unit testing. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.